You understand? So that is part of being منقطع. Some people when they call hadith مرسل معضل, and some other in the they don't mean broken. They mean it's very weak. This hadith is very weak. You understand? That is that terminology.
So you have to know people's terminology.
It's fine to know the terminology. Good to know the terminology of people. Sometimes it's very necessary to know the terminology, especially if you rely on them.
Yeah.
If you rely on them in any way. In any way. Also, such as when you see someone saying thiqa and you understand, or saduq or hasan hadith, or this is also you have to know, because if you are going to say this person is trustworthy because so and so said, so you have to understand the terminology as well. It's very important. So he said by saying this, from this definition, any hadith which is mursal, munqati', mu'dal, or shad, or there is illa qadiha in it. Illa qadiha. Now what he said illa qadiha? Illa qadiha means illa that is effective illa. Some illa may not be effective. It looks like illa.
So qadiha means it's too much.
Illa qadiha, no, it's not too much. Illa qadiha is effective. I give you illa qadiha here. مدلس narrates hadith from someone and he doesn't say حدثنا. That is علة in hadith. تدليس is علة. You look at the hadith, apparently it's صحيح. But yes, الأعمش from إبراهيم النخعي, الأعمش is مدلس. And we couldn't find anywhere that he said this hadith حدثنا. So that is علة. Should be قادحة. But then someone narrated not all the hadith. The hadith comes from A'mash, from Ibrahim al-Nakhai. But someone narrated the hadith. Whether he mentioned the whole hadith or mentioned part of the hadith himself, and then he said, when I was narrating this hadith from Ibrahim al-Nakhai, A'mash was sitting next to me when I heard this hadith. Now he proved from another place that Ibrahim actually here, A'mash has heard this hadith. At the beginning we will say this hadith is da'if, but someone else actually has said that. You understand? So we say this is not qadiha. It's not
effective.
You understand? So this is illa, yes, but it's not effective. It's not to be used. Some illa are not a problem. You understand? So if we can, if we find it should have been illa, but then we have proven, we have found solution for it. You understand? A blind has written a letter. Qatada Awza'i said Qatada wrote to me.
Qatada was blind.
Yes.
Yeah.
Now Qatada,
yeah.
You understand? Awza'i said Qatada wrote to me. Now this is illa, because this hadith is in Muslim. It's fine. But then you think, okay, how can Qatada write to Awza'i when he was born as blind, he could never write. So he ordered someone else to write. This someone else, we don't know who he is. This is illa, no? Understand?
Okay.
Unless we find somewhere else who he is, the person who wrote for him.
We won't find him.
Huh? Well, you won't find it here.
Yeah.
So this is illa qadiha. You understand? So he said,
which hadith is this?
The hadith of Anas ibn Malik, when he said, I prayed behind the Prophet and Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman, and they all start with Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. They don't say Bismillah Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. No, this hadith, there is so many narrations. The majority say that he used to start with Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. That's all.
Perfect.
Yes. But then people understood that starting with Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen means he doesn't say Bismillah Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. and then added this. He doesn't say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim from their heads because they understood it that way. Well, Anas ibn Malik, what he meant, he starts with Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Surah Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen.
Surah Fatiha.
Yes, they call it Surah Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. This is how the Prophet used to call it anyway. So, he says, this hadith is the hadith he added here. So he said, by mentioning this, the hadith Mursal, Munqati', Mu'tal, Shad, and where there is illa, all these are out. We don't include it in the hadith sahih. And anything that has any kind of injury, jarh, we call it jarh. Hadith jarh.
Isn't that illa? Injury is illa.
No, injury is not jarh. So something else. Something else will be the person being weak. We don't call this illa.
Okay.
Understand? So many people will call hadith ma'lul. It's not sahih because the narrator is daif. But we say we refer to illa only illa, which is you can't see it. Apparently, is not there. Okay. Understand? So a person being weak in the hadith, people generally don't call it. The muhaddithin, the general muhaddithin, they don't call it ma'lul. When they say ma'lul, they mean something a hidden illa. Okay? So if someone narrates hadith from Ata al-Khurasani, someone narrating hadith from Shahr ibn al-Hawshab, or Nabhan Mawla Salam, Nabhan Mawla Salama from Salama, that what is his name? The Abdullah ibn Maktum, the blind, came to them, and then the Prophet said, ordered them to cover themselves, like to not to look at him, and then to cover themselves. And then they said he is blind. He said, but you are not blind. You understand? This hadith is daif. He said, Afa'um yawani antuma. What about you two? Are you blind? So the majority don't take this hadith, and they say it's fine for a woman to look at a man, but a man not to look at a woman. You understand?
Now, what's the effect of this?
No, the hadith is narration of Nabhan Mawla Salama, and it is considered to be da'if. So this, we don't say this hadith is ma'lul. The person is clearly da'if, finished. The hadith is rejected. So it is we say this hadith is da'if then. So if a person is da'if in the isnad, we just reject the hadith. People generally, they call this hadith da'if. They don't say it's ma'lul because it's clear. The mistake is clear. Okay?
Okay, if he was not known.
If he was not?
No.
That is
majhul.
Majhul, that is a ta'f as well. Hadith of majhul is considered to be da'if. No, it's not considered to be illa. Illa, I told you, defection is something that you don't see.
You can't see it.
At the beginning, at the first sight, probably you might not see it. People who have knowledge of hadith will know it, but generally other people might not know it. People who are beginners in hadith might not realize that. He says this is the hadith which is considered to be sahih, with no set different opinions. Like everybody agree that some hadith is considered to be sahih. The fact that it is a narration of trustworthy, from trustworthy until the Prophet, without not being broken, there is no shudud, there is no illah. So this is, everybody agrees to be sahih. Some people might not consider all these conditions, but if there is these conditions, then this is, no one will disagree that this hadith is sahih. Also it makes sense. Allah ordered us to not to say about him what we don't know. Yeah. Now how you know it, that is left to you to know it, to know. You have to prove it. You have to explain it, and you understand. So when you have, once you have, you have to explain, I mean the hadith, when we take hadith, we all the usul of hadith, we don't take them from Quran and Sunnah only. We take them from what it makes sense as well. Because Allah ordered us to take, not to lie about Him, and to accept what He has said. So there is a way how to, in you, these ways here, they should not be contradicting the Quran and Sunnah.
Did we take in hadith?
Yes. Allah ordered us to take hadith, to take His saying. Now He's saying how to take it and not to lie about Him. Not to accept anything, meaning not to lie about Him, not to accept everything that people have said.
Mm-hmm.
Now, and to keep away from doubts. Now, within the rules that Allah have said, we know that there is hadith definitely. Ati'u Rasul, the Prophet. So there is definitely something that is comes from the Prophet. We have to take it.
Mm-hmm.
How to take it? Where to get it from? How to take it? Since Allah didn't make the usul of the hadith, that's mean for us to work out how to find this hadith is sahih or not. So you use for that your intellect.
Yeah.
Things that make sense.
Yeah.
As long as you don't contradict anything from the religion. So for example, you will say, oh, this person is a kafir. But he is going. Khair inshallah. You will say this person is kafir, but he is not a liar. He will never lie. You understand? He is known that he is very careful. He doesn't lie. Now it makes sense to take this hadith, but then you will be contradicting Quran that says, "In ja'akum fasiqun binaba'in fatabayyanu." Anything that kafir have said or fasiq have said, that if it can't be verified through another person who is trustworthy, then it should be rejected. Otherwise, you will be contradicting Quran. As from other things, now the other matters where there is no Quran saying anything, then you might like shad, one contradicting many. I mean, there is a hadith from Umar al-Khattab which is so and so, it's fine, it's fine, just fine, in Muslim, in Tirmidhi, that says the Prophet, عليكم بالجماعة, stay with the jama'a, because the shaitan is with the one. And he is farther from the two. And then you can use this to back the opinion of the majority that Shad is da'if. You understand? Especially that the shaitan, people forget because of the shaitan. وَمَا أَنْسَنِيهُ إِلَّا الشَّيْطَانُ وَأَنْ أَذْكُرَهُ. The shaitan makes you forget. So you can use this hadith to say Shad, like if you try probably hard, you might find for every rule that they bring, and they say, you might find something from the hadith of Quran. You understand? So, so this hadith is the hadith that we consider to be sahih, with no different opinion amongst the muhadithin. He said, but sometimes they may differ in some hadith. That is not because they differ in the definition, or they differ on the matter. You understand? On this rule, no. They might differ in whether this hadith that they are talking about meet the conditions or not. So they agree that hadith which is of the trustworthy and connected to be taken. But then the problem is this person trustworthy or not? That is what makes the hadith sahih to some according to somebody and da'if according to some others. Some will say this hadith is trustworthy, this person is trustworthy, and therefore I will take his hadith. The other person will say, no, this hadith is not
because it's
from, you understand? Or they might say, this hadith is connected. Another person will say, no, this hadith is not connected. Yeah? Bukhari, according to Bukhari, there is many hadith in Muslim that he will consider not to be connected, because his ways of considering people to be, he want to know
That they have met. Unlike Muslim.
Muslim, the fact that it is possible that they have met, that is enough for him. That is the opinion of the majority.
Muslims?
The Muslim opinion, yes. He put it in such... The majority always wants someone to shout. You understand? When someone starts shouting, they go with him. They say he's right.
Like
if he is not right, he will not be shouting like this. So Muslim.